You want a license?
Yes.
For a fish?
Yes.
You are a loony.
Look, it's a feeding pet, isn't it? I've got a license for me pet dog, Eric, and I've got a license for me pet cat, Eric.
You don't need a license for a cat.
You bloody well do, and I've got one. Oh, you're not kitching me out there.
There is no such thing as a bloody cat license.
Yes, there is.
No, there isn't.
Is.
Isn't.
You.
Isn't. Isn't. That is a dog license with the word dog crossed out and the word cat written in ink pen.
Well, the man didn't have a proper form.
The man from the cat detector van.
Loony detector van, you mean?
It's people like you what causes unrest.
All right, what cat detector van?
The cat detector van for the Ministry of Housing.
Housing?
It's spelt that way on the van. I'm very observant. I've never seen so many aerials in my life. The man told me their equipment could pinpoint a purr at 400 yards. And Eric, being such a happy cat, was a piece of cake.
How much did this cost?
60 quid and 8 guineas for the fruit bat.
What fruit bat?
Eric the fruit bat.
And all your pets called Eric?
There's nothing so odd about that. Kemal Ataturk had an entire menagerie all called Abdul.
No, he didn't.
Did. There you are. Kemal Ataturk, the man by E.W. Swanton, with a forward five pool anchor. Page 91, please.
I owe you an apology, sir.
Spare them like a gentleman. Now, are you going to give me this fish license?
I promise you there is no such thing. You don't need one.
Then I would like a statement to that effect, signed by the Lord Mayor.
You're in luck.
And now, there is the Mayor. Surely the third tallest mayor in Derby's history. And there are the aldermen, magnificently resplendent in their aldermanic hose. And just look at the power in those thighs. The New Zealanders are going to find it pretty tough going in the set pieces in the second half. So Dawn Palethorpe with one clear round on Sir Gerald. And now the mayor has reached the great customer, Mr. Eric Praline. And now the mayoral human being takes the mayoral pen in his mayoral hand and, watched by the Lady Mayoress, who of course scored that magnificent try in the first half, signs the fishy exemption. And the great customer, Mr. Eric Praline, who is understandably awed by the magnificence and even the absurdity of this great occasion here at Cardiff Arms Park, has finally gone spare. And there is the going spare look on the front of his head. And now the aldermen are finishing their oranges and leaving the post office for the start of the second half.
Here come the Derby Council 15 following the All Blacks out onto the pitch. There at the in the centre of the pitch you can see Dawn Palethorpe on Sir Gerald, one of the fastest wingers we must have seen in England this season. On the left-hand side of the pitch, the Lord Mayor has been running such wonderful possession for Derby Council in the lines out. And it's the All Blacks to kick off, Wilson to kick off. Oh, and I can see there the chairman of the Byways and Highways Committee, who's obviously recovered from that very nasty blow he got in that loose ball in the first half. And Wilson kicks off, and it's the Town Talks taking the ball beautifully there. The All Blacks are up on it very fast, and the whistler's gone. I'm not quite sure what happened there. I couldn't see, but there's a scrum down. I think it's an All Blacks ball. Well, they were up on them very fast. Obviously, they're going to try very hard in this half to wipe out this five-point deficit. Derby Council, 8 points to three up, and Derby Council have got the ball against the head. There is the Borough Surveyor, the scrum half, is out of the chairway of the chairman of the Highway and Byway Committee, who's kicked for touch. The line out, and it's in. The line out, and the Mayor has got the ball again to the Borough Surveyor. He's left out the medical officer of health, straight along the line to the Lady Mayoress, and the Lady Mayoress is going to go through. Number two is Mister, who's taking up the fullback, who's only the fullback to beat, and she has scored. The Lady Mayoress has scored. It's 11 points to three.
Cliff, this must have been a very disappointing result for the All Blacks.
Well, they've had very bad luck on the tour so far. In fact, they missed four very easy kicks against the Exeter Amateur Operatic Society, which must have cost them the match. And then, of course, there was that crippling defeat at the hands of the Derry and Tom Soft Toy Department. So I don't think they can really be fancying their chances against the London Poofs on Saturday.
And what about China?
Well, whether Mao Zedong is alive or not, Lin Piao has a stranglehold on the Central Committee, which Lin Shaoqi can't break. So it remains to be seen whether Chu Enlai can really get his finger out and get going in the second half.
Well, thank you, Cliff. Tonight's other outstanding match was the semi-final between the Bournemouth gynecologists and the Watford Long John Silver impersonators. We bring you edited highlights of the match. About it tonight, ladies and gentlemen. But remember, if you've enjoyed watching the show just half as much as we've enjoyed doing it, then we've enjoyed it twice as much as you.